I don't want to hear anything about the club. That's me, personally. No, I want something to uplift me. I want something to take me someplace else, not to let me wallow in my sorrow, but to give me that strength that let me know Mark is going to be okay. Where can I find it? That's the question.
How hard was it to stay this positive when you were in that gated community? When you were in prison, how hard was it to stay positive like you are now?
You know, whatever I say, and I don't know if I can just play. If you're a pussy in the streets, you're a pussy in prison. It's a much smaller place for it to be revealed. So I was never one in the streets, so I couldn't be one in prison. You understand? I find myself mentoring a lot of people, you know, giving a lot of people strength, hope. At one point, you know, driving the car, you find that in those places are designed not only to break the human spirit, but to destroy the very fabric of the human mind. A weak mind cannot emerge strong from those places, just weaker, because they spend every day trying to subdue it. They are not given the opportunity to learn and expound and new ideas and creative things, because again, they said you're incarcerated, but then there is so much illicit stuff for sale that you wonder if you're really incarcerated. The challenge is, if you're not a man, but no foundation in spirituality, you're like a ship left to the wind. If you have even a modicum, even an iota, you'll be okay, because then you're in a place where you can cultivate your growth. So then, that's what I did, cultivate my growth. You know, I was there physically, but not mentally, never. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, and thanks to a great book, I started reading by this guy called Viktor Frankl, Man's Search for Meaning.
Man's Search for Meaning.
Now, Viktor Frankl was in prison, you know, Holocaust camp, one in place where they kill all the Jews, and I find myself in a similar situation like him. I would project myself on stage, project myself doing things that I would normally do at various colleges and universities, talking with the children, whatever I would do. I would project myself among my family, project myself with my dogs. I lived in my mind's eye, and in doing so, I cultivated peace, even against my oppressors. Because you cannot tell me that the greatest intelligence apparatus on earth was able to see a meeting with that ace, that death, that other push button, that other fear. So you have to relinquish that illness towards your fellow man. And I will not say, Father, forgive them, because they knew not what they have done. No, I said, Father, forgive them, but they know what they did. Okay?
Yes, sir.
All right.
And that can be really hard for you, because you know yourself, right? And then the media puts out a story that you know this is not how things went down, but they try to make it seem like you're engaged in activities that you know doesn't.
Yes. And that is the way it is in the United States of America's court system. You have to realize a court is where tennis is played, court soccer. It's a game. Unfortunately, we are behind in the game, in the rules of the game. You understand? And so, we suffer. I was reading a book the other day about a federal prosecutor from Washington, D.C., who found himself on the other side of the law. Not by doing anything nefarious, but just something simple. And the way his whole case was manipulated and twisted, then opened his eyes that he was a scumbag, working for scumbags, you know, and doing wicked things to fit in with his peers. Like, oh, you think because I'm black, I'm not gonna smash them or... And then the dawn came upon him, and he realized. You know, it was a great dawn coming up all over the world. A lot of awakening, a lot of eyes are opening. The world cannot be kept in darkness forever, in a system. We're going to have visions. We're going to see.